For the 2020 and beyond. What you want? This the poetry jam. I don't got friends, I got fam. For the 2020 and beyond. What you want?
Y'all, this is just me talking about my honest thoughts on the program. I was kind of hesitant about it because I was like, is it really that big of a deal for me to address it? Is it going to actually fix my problem? That was what I was thinking. And then also I was hesitant because I didn't really want to change. I was like, if I go to this program at this church, they're going to make me change. And I don't really want to change. Like, I was really like, no. But then it took me from being mute, because I never really was talking like this, because I was always afraid of what other people think of me. And I was really self-conscious. But now I'm like, I got confidence now. You know, I can pursue my dreams like I always wanted to, you know, without worrying about, okay, I wonder who gonna say something about it. You know, I still be wondering that sometimes, but then I kind of just be like putting it to the side and just freely being myself. Like, it's not like I have to put on a front to be myself. I can just be myself. I can actually have self-confidence. And, you know, I just thank God for that. You know, because a friend of mine, she prophesied to me like a few years ago about confronting this little girl. And I was like, I can't even connect with those emotions, because that was a long time ago. Like, this assault happened so long ago. So, and it happened twice. So I was like, okay, why confront it now? But I'm glad I did. I'm glad I did that. Like, I'm definitely a different person today than I was. And anybody back home can tell you how they remember me. And they still feel like I might be quiet, because I am reserved. But I definitely have a lot more confidence than I had before I even stepped foot into that door. And I really didn't know it was going to make this much of a difference. But I just thank God I did it. And you could do it too. It's worth it.